Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. We're live streaming right here on YouTube and I'm excited to be back with you. I really am. It's a whole different energy when I'm here with you live than just uploading a video onto the website. So let me know when you join in. I'm not sure if we have the live stream going from the last live stream. So let me know when you're here. Let me know when you're here. And today, okay, Big A's back. He's an all-star. Gotta love him. Neymar's here, another name we hear all the time. Thank you all for joining. Hey, so here's what I'm going to do today. I want you to make money, period. I want you to understand how to make money. I know we're teaching you how to, make the music better so that you have a better product to present to the world, but you also have to know how to monetize it properly, how to stand out from the next guy. Because I was listening to a bunch of interviews, a bunch of podcasts. They give you the most vague information, and it bothers me because it's so vague. They're like, get out there and grind. You know, get out there, grind. Go ahead and hustle. I mean, yes, those are terms you want to do. But if they're not giving you a step-by-step, how can you hustle if you don't know how to hustle? So it's my duty to share and give you tips here. So what I'm going to do, I'm trying to think of how I want to do it. I want to do a partial feedback here. Instead of feedback, let's do it this way. Let me ask you a question in the chat. Which website do you think you should use to sell beats? And I ask that because I want to go through each website and show you how everybody looks the same. And then once we see how everybody looks the same, we're going to go into a specific brand. And then from that specific brand, we're going to break down the commerce. Pornhub. That's funny. YouTube. Okay, so there's a lot of different answers here. So we got YouTube, No One, Bandcamp, my own website, Track Train. That's another one I've heard of. BeatStars, Almighty BDS. BeatStars, I've seen a video on something before. That's a long paragraph. Hold on. Guys showed the same chords used in every song. I felt sick because I used the same chords for everything. That's why I wanted to learn jazz chords. Okay, Blood Dragon. We'll go over more stuff in our music theory courses. So I'm seeing a lot of BeatStars and YouTube. Okay, so let's start at YouTube because I think this is the new thing that people are complaining about. So because they think it's saturated. And once you think an industry is saturated, then you've already nailed yourself to the cross. So let's see. What type of beat should I look up? Which type beat should I search? Now, the reason I'm doing this is because I think type beat is the way people look up stuff. So let's just assume people are looking up type beat. And then we're going to go through a whole sales system of how it works and how everybody does the same exact sales system. And I'm not going to say it doesn't work. If they're getting paid, it works. But everybody is doing the same exact thing the same way. That's the problem. There's no differentiation. So, Marcellus Beats. Never heard of that. Metro Boomin type beat. A lot of people might look that up. Lo-fi. A lot of people might look that up. Future type beat. You and Pornhub, Sebastian. Somebody told me my ads are popping up on these like websites. I'm like, I don't know if they're joking or not. Because I know Facebook and all these Google, they have a huge network, so I don't know which sites they're popping up on. Hold on one sec. Why is slow mode on? It's to prevent spam. That's what it's for. Okay, so I'm looking up Young Thug, Future. What was the first one? I forgot that quick. Metro Boomin. So let's look up Metro Boomin. Let's look up Lo-Fi. Let's do Metro Boomin first. Metro Boomin type beat. Let me show you how everybody does the same exact thing. Now, to you, this may all look different, right? It may look like, okay, they all did different thumbnails, so they're all different. But let's show you how they're the same exact thing. They all have a picture of who in the thumbnail? Metro Boomin. Okay, they all have a picture of something. This one says Future, and it has Future in the thumbnail. This one has Metro Boomin in the thumbnail. You scroll down, Metro Boomin in the thumbnail, Future in the thumbnail. 21 Savage, because that's the key word here, so on and so forth, in the thumbnail. So automatically, they use the celebrity as their thumbnail. Okay, secondly, they write some type of text, so they'll put the title of the track in the thumbnail. So in this case, Metro Boomin Perfect Timing. So almost they're treating this almost like it's an iTunes search function or something. Like they're treating it as if people are clinging on it because that's the song. This came from the iTunes model, and that's the problem that a lot of people just can't shake. They think that's the only way to do business. I'm not hating on these guys. He could be doing great. This is not shade to DJ Vibe at all. I'm just saying. I'm looking at the commonalities between all these. So you see Metro Boomin, Tidal, and then, okay, here's another thing I've noticed. The titles are like one word or two words. You know, when did that become a thing? I know if you've noticed in the movies, their movies used to be called like How to Escape Paradise or like, you know, long movie names. It used to be, you know, real movie names. Now it's like one word movies like The Edge, The Giraffe, The Critic. You know, it's like the word. So the movies are doing it too. Now, I'm not going to say it works or doesn't work, but that's something that people are copying from each other. You can clearly see here, one word, freeze, one word, jug, one word, again, one word, well, actually, no, it's two words, this is two words as well. So, you got to be, if you're going to do, okay, there's a lot of things you got to think about. One is, are you using the word as a keyword, or are you using it as a title? If you're not using it as a keyword, what's the point of using one word? Because again, right? When you're thinking of a hook, you don't think of one word unless it's like Hannah Montana, Hannah Montana, Hannah Montana, Hannah Montana is the same word over and over and over again. Hooks usually aren't like that. You know, it's a phrase. And not only is it a phrase, it helps you search it out better. If I Google the word again, there's going to be, let's Google the word again. I mean, the chances of that song coming up. Wow, Fetty Wap has a song called Again. So that just completely busted my argument. So that was random. But let's use Jug. And this is no shade to anybody on that list. I just want to show you how we all do the same things subconsciously. Fetty Wap has a song called Jug. What's up with this Fetty Wap? So I guess people are taking Fetty Wap song titles. Let's try Freeze. No way. If Fetty Wap has a song named Freeze, I'm done. Okay, so you look up the word freeze, nothing pops up but dictionary definitions. There's nothing about music anywhere here. Okay, so when people are... Okay, so you got to think of a song as a lot of different parts. The point of the lyric of a song and the hook is so that people memorize it and then go Google search it. So when Drake says, what's that song? Yeah, I like to drink. Yeah, I smoke. You know, yeah, I like to drink. Yeah, I smoke. People Google that and say, what song was that? Oh, it's called Both. So the song is called Both, but the hook is really longer. It's a phrase because people memorize a chain of words more than just one word. It's harder to find a song with one word. You want to have a long tail keyword, it's called. So hopefully that's the first technique. You want to elongate your titles. I'm not saying this is going to work for everybody, but I'm saying in the long term, you got to start thinking that way. Again, what's your formula? Is it to use the artist's picture and do the same thing with the title? I mean, it's you got to differentiate yourself. Okay, so enough criticizing about the thumbnails and the keywords. Let's click here. I don't want to get a copyright strike, so I'm going to have to click here and mute it right away. No, okay. Okay, so let's mute YouTube videos. So you come here, it looks like, now here's another thing I've noticed. Now, again, this is no shade to anybody, but I've noticed it's become a trend to take music video footage and just rip it and put it on your beat thing. Now, I'm pretty sure the companies don't want you doing that. But again, I'm not trying to call anybody out. I'm just saying I would look, instead of doing that, I would go to a site called Video Blocks. They give you royalty free. You have to pay for it, but they give you royalty free background footage. So you're not like ripping from other people's videos. Because I don't think that's, I think that's, you know, you really have to dig into the YouTube policy. So I've noticed that it's not just this person. I'm not even calling them out. And sorry if I've offended you, but that's not the point of what I was getting at. My point is you want to do a different approach. So go to Video Blocks, look up Let's see, footage of, they used to have a visual. I don't know why it's not visual. Let's do footage of, they used to have like slow motion. I don't know where it went. Oh, here we go. Slow motion. And then you have this stuff in your background. Okay. And you can change it. You don't have to use just rain. You could use roses. It, this is more emotional than tying, than literally ripping it from somebody's music video. This is going to tie into a deeper emotion for a lot of different reasons. Like, I'm not going to get into everything about emotions, but that's that. Okay, so that's another thing you could do. Sorry if I'm missing your questions. Leave a, if you have a question, try adding 3 question marks. That way I can see it a little more clearly. It's hard to see question marks. How do you stop PayPal buyback charges? You can't, okay? PayPal favors the buyer. If people are going to rip you off, they're just going to do that. That's how they are in life. That's, they're just going to do that. But I'm not sure if you mean the chargebacks, which charges you $20, like out of your pocket. I think that's because people use third-party credit cards. And when they have the chargeback, the bank charges PayPal and you get the fee. Something like that. I forget how it works. But try to limit it to PayPal users only versus opening it up to third-party credit cards. Now, at the same time, you're blocking yourself from more opportunity. So that's something you just either have to switch merchants, switch your, instead of using PayPal, use somebody else, or you know, just deal with the precautions there. That's the thing about PayPal. It gives the users more power, but also it lets more people do business with you because they trust PayPal. So it's a trade-off. Thoughts on sending out beats for free when you're starting out? When you're starting out, I think you should hustle as much as you can. Do whatever you have to do to get people's attention. And then once you get people's attention, you get to create the rules. Okay. Sorry if I'm missing your questions. Hold on. Looked like a good question up here. Thoughts on Google? You think it's better to have a style of music and cater to a smaller market or have a wider variety of beats and target a mass audience? I think mass audience is the way you should go right away. Getting too niched out, getting too specific might not motivate you enough. So that's what I would think of. What does this want? Change color scheme to wave. Yes, whatever. Okay, I have no idea what that just did. Okay, style. Okay, so a lot of people are focusing on the product. You got to focus on everything else in this video. That's kind of the key to this video. We're not worried about what the beat sounds like. We're worried about everything else. Hey, I'm 13 years old. How do I start selling my beats? This video is going to help you at least understand a little bit about it. We have a whole course on how to sell beats online at busyworksbeats.com/sellbeats. I'm going to update the course with newer information. Plus, I want to ask you a question. Succeed with a trap beat. Old Egyptian melody. Go for it. Do I F with the war? With what war? I don't know what war we're in. I don't like war. I think war is too much. How can I add samples in FL Unlimited? We have videos on sampling. Just type in sampling BusyWorks beats. So let me get, oh wait, hold on. Let me get to a question about this topic. Do you know any services where you can sell your music without having to pay royalties? Yeah, use any e-commerce website. So there's different beat selling websites. Use whatever you're comfortable with. I'm not going to tell you that this is better than this. You could use Shopify. You can use any beat selling website. You can use e-commerce websites. You can use whatever. I mean, the choices are broad. I wouldn't do a site that takes a percentage. However, I would do a site that does not take a percentage. Even if you have to pay a monthly fee, just to kind of understand what business is about, I'd do that first before you start going on your own, doing your own thing. Sorry, I missed a bunch of questions somewhere. I had to reload the chat. So let me get back to my point. This is just a case study. So DJ Vibe, if you're watching this, again, I'm not criticizing you. I'm just showing what people are doing. Here's another thing. Everybody kind of started this bracket thing. This is free, right? Everybody does the whatever, whatever, and then type beat, and then a year. I'm not hating on you for doing it, okay? But everybody's doing the same thing. So how do you differentiate yourself from everybody else? You do the opposite. Okay, that's the quickest way. You do the complete opposite of what everybody else is doing. So let's look into the YouTube description. Again, same format, you know, the money bag, the email thing. I'm not hating on it. It's just everybody's doing it. So just be aware of that. Okay, and then the BeatStars link, of course. I would, however, not use an email in the description, because what can happen is spam spiders, or whatever they're called, can climb through and take your email and then spam you to death. But if you have a good email client like Gmail, it can, you know, weed out the spam. But at the same time, you might be weeding out important information because you're missing emails because they're getting sent to spam. So you really want to be careful with putting your email out, you know, in regular format on the internet, period, unless you have a really strong spam filter. Again, I mean, you're going to see this everywhere we go. You're going to see the same exact format. So they could all have the different music, but everything else is the same. So it's kind of like going into a room, you're trying to attract girls, and everybody's wearing the same exact suit, the same exact clothes, everything from the head to the toes, the same exact thing. They all have a name badge that has a different name, but they're all wearing the same exact thing. The only thing that's different is the person inside that nobody knows. You would have to talk to them to get to know the man inside. And I feel like the way you have an advantage in the dating world or in life, if you're in a physical space, is to stand out from everybody else visually, or stand out from everybody else, period, so that you don't look like everybody else in the room. And that's the kind of syndrome that we get as producers. We get so creative with the music, but then skimp on everything else. Okay, so this is, again, I'm not hating on this guy, but you can't do this in YouTube. So if you're doing this on your YouTube page, you can risk your channel getting strikes and all this type of stuff, because it's against the terms. You can't put keywords in your description. Just heads up, okay? Let's go to the website. I think it was BeatStars. Again, I'm going to have to mute it. Hurry up and mute. I don't know where the play buttons are. Okay, so this site's a little bit different than what I'm used to seeing. But for the most part, it's kind of like the same thing over and over again, but I mean, as far as what I keep saying about it, but you're going to see a player, you're going to see leasing prices. I'm actually shocked this person says licensing, thank goodness, instead of lease. You see licensing or leasing, and then you usually see the terms. This one's a little bit different. So it's a little bit different. It looks like the SoundClick type of style. But when people come here, yes, your music can sell itself, but you also have to sell your music. So you have to, there's sales to this. Just hitting plays is not necessarily going to sell something. So you want to learn about what sells stuff. I want you to go to Walmart, right? The picture of the, let's go to walmart.com for a second. And let's equate what people are doing on these Beat websites with walmart.com, for example. So when I come to your Beat website, I see a picture of the product, or maybe Febreze, a bottle of Febreze or something. And then I see the price of Febreze. And then I see, you know, other products that look like Febreze, let's just say. When you go to walmart.com, now the difference is that people who send you to Walmart do a lot of what's called advertising. They do pre-sales. So they're giving you a lot of information and reasons why you should buy something before you even step into Walmart. So the work is being done before you're there. They're not just putting up a can of Febreze and expecting you to buy it. You know, it's the same mentality we have, you know, with music. So let's click on this Captain Crunch Berries. Now, a lot of people are like, why are you clicking on this Captain Crunch Berries thing? You're probably thinking that, and you're saying, what does this have to do with selling beats? It's because if you can sell Captain Crunch Berries, you can sell beats, you can sell music. Selling is, it doesn't matter what you're selling, it's the same craft. It's just like music production. It doesn't matter what genre you're making, you still have to know what filtering is, compression, you still have to know what frequencies are. It's the same thing, it's just a different genre. So let's look at this page and see what makes people buy this off the website. Now, the website in this case is acting as a pre-sales function, a reason to buy this Captain Crunch Berries. They're not just showing me a picture and saying $5.57, checkout. You know, they're giving me more information about the product. And this is what companies do in advertising before you step into Walmart. So even though they might not have a sales pitch at Walmart, they have it in commercials getting you to Walmart, and that's where you pick it up. So look at this page. It's more than just a picture and different, you know, angles of the bag in different bags of cereal. It's okay. Highlights: mega bag, high or excellent source of vitamins, minerals, low saturated fat. Now we all know this probably has tons of sugar. Okay. Wow. 43 servings of 11 grams. That's 430 plus grams of sugar in this container of cereal. But their highlight is that it's high in an excellent source of minerals and vitamins, yet it has 430 grams of sugar. So you have to highlight the good parts about your product, okay, and make it seem bigger than what it is, in a good way. Mega bag, you know, why didn't they just say big bag? They called it a mega bag. So you're getting a super dose of Captain Crunch, low saturated fat, but high sugar. They're not talking about the sugar content. They're talking about everything else. So, you know, and then they go about this item. So there's a lot more than just the thing of Captain Crunch and then a buy button. But that's what producers are skipping. They're skipping reasons why people should buy your thing, or pre-sales. They're skipping the whole selling process, period. So you're just showing me a song and expecting me to buy it. So that's what you need to understand is the problem. So now I wasn't meaning to dig into DJ Vibe, but that's the greater issue I want to tackle today. So let's look up, let's give some feedback on somebody's site here, so you get a takeaway. So who's brave enough to send in your site for review? First person gets a site review, whoever's first. See ya, Mr. Brian. Appreciate you coming in. Yep, this will be on the channel for review. I'm trying to give you a solid understanding of what actually sells music. Okay, so me, Existence Music. Oh, I need a link. Let's see. I guess you're on YouTube. Is this your page? No, that doesn't match your... Here we go. Okay, uploads MIDI pack. Let's do something that is... Do you have like a website? Let me see. SoundCloud. Okay. So for me, I'm trying to figure out what your product is, for one. That's the first confusion part. And how to get to your main website. I'm assuming your main website is SoundCloud. All right. So in the beginning, you're going to do all this like I used to do. Have a Twitter, a Facebook, an Instagram. Try cutting your links down, because it's too much. It's just too much stuff. We're leading people in a circle of social media. There's no like end goal. So you want to have an end goal. You want to have a website that you want people to visit, or a main place you want people to visit. And then you're going to use all these websites like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter. They're all going to send people to that specific website. So instead of having like every website on top of every website, it just leaves us in a big circle. We're not really ending anywhere. Top link, Existence Shop. Oh, whoops. Well, I missed it. Show more. Top link. Oh, maybe on SoundCloud. There we go. Okay, so I would cut out literally all these things. I know that sounds dramatic, but try it. You're going to get more people more inclined to click that, even though it's a very, very small link. I didn't even notice it was there, but I'm sure you have buy buttons and things. So I would cut out all these links, because it's just giving people a reason to go to a different website than your main website. So let's go to your main website. Okay, so it looks like a catalog type of view. From first view, I wouldn't understand that this is anything about commerce. It looks more like a showcase type of thing. And I understand not everybody has full control of the website design. But to me, when I first came here, it just looks like a catalog. I don't really have that shopping vibe. So let's click here anyway. So this track, I'm not going to play it, but you have... Okay, so you sell the individual tracks. I'm assuming it's a song. Let me see. Hope the track makes you dance. Wait. Oh, it's an instrumental. Okay. So people can go through and have your instrumental. So let's look at this track specifically, and let's see what is making anybody buy it besides the music itself. Let's see. I think this track, so here's the beginning of the sales page. Everything else is kind of Bandcamp's thing. So it says, I think this track hits hard. If you want to do a vocal for this instrumental, feel free to contact me. I hope this track makes you dance like it did for me. This is Vanilla by Existence Music. If you would like to use any of my tracks, feel free to contact me from the info below. All your feedback and support is greatly appreciated. Thanks for listening. So this is like a letter to the listener. What I would do is make this letter more strategic. So you have to kind of understand how to write sales letters. That's just a skill that you have to learn. I can't teach you how to do that. But instead of making it like a note, you want to make this a reason why people should buy this song. Because there's nothing on the page that tells me I should buy the song. It's just nothing on the page even tells me to play the song. So you have to give people a reason to buy that song, or you know what it's for. And one more thing I would do on your page is try bundling things, putting things in a group. So instead of just one song at a time, I would group them together and offer a group of songs for a certain price. Bandcamp's a little confusing for me. Maybe this is the store. It's just like a catalog. You click it and play. But when I come here, the way the website's built is that it's blocking me. So, okay, there's an intermediate step. So let's say we went on your YouTube, okay? And then we went to your SoundCloud. That's two steps, okay? Now we go to your website. That's three steps. Now we go to this page. That's four steps of action. And if you watch any, let's say, any series on TV, the chances of you watching it all the way through are slim. You know, you might stop halfway through. The more actions you require, the more likely people are to go somewhere else, meaning like leave the website or do something else, because we have ADD as a society. So we're going to click on a new tab and go to Twitter, and then we're just going to forget about whatever we were on. So you want to make the gap as short as possible. The only time you want to introduce that many steps is if you want to filter out people on purpose. Okay, but if you're selling something, the more steps it takes, the worse. I mean, as far as getting to your web page. So again, we go to one social media, which I would include your website here. It's just easier because the whole point of social media is to send people directly to your website. So instead of sending me to another social media, go immediately to your website, right, and YouTube. That way it cuts down on all those steps. And then we go straight to your website. Now, I'm not sure how Bandcamp works as far as the layouts and all this. I understand you might not have full control over this. But I would make this more like, instead of titles, we need to understand what the heck it is. We need to understand, is it an art piece? Is it music? What is it? What am I looking at? So, you know, a little more clarity on that page. That way we have a reason to click something. So hopefully that gave you a little more clarity. I'm not bashing on you. I understand you're using different platforms and it can be confusing if you don't have full creative control. So I understand that part. I just wanted to make that clear. The jump to your website should be immediate. So you want to get rid of all of these social media loops because it just sends people back and forth, and they end up not going to the website. So let's look up somebody else's website. What's the website 30 minutes ago? How I'm getting all these things. Oh, well, congratulations. Yeah, I'm not here to like bash you. I think once you have that mindset, you're going to see your efforts give you a greater result. So the more time you put into your YouTube, you're going to see people going to your website. The more time you put into your SoundCloud, you're going to see people going to your website versus the more effort you put in the SoundCloud, people are going to your Instagram, you know, and that doesn't lead to people buying anything because you can't sell anything on Instagram. So the more you focus that traffic, the better. All right, so let's look up a different website. Who's man enough or woman enough to list the link to your website? Oh, billshiba.com. Sounds sketchy. I'm going to have to Google this, make sure it's not a naughty website. Oh, no, it's not. I just wanted to make sure. Because it sounds a little bit different. Okay, music. Let's say billshiba.com. So this is, we're going directly to your website. All right, so it sounds like music. How do I pause it? Not sure. Okay, so a lot of flash. But here's the other balance. So here's the other part of the extreme. The other part of the extreme is having too much stuff going on. So here, it's so elegant and so detailed that I have no idea where I'm at. I see a play button, obviously. I would hit play, but I don't know what's going on. So that's one thing you want to make clear. And another thing I've noticed with these websites that these companies allow you to build, you got to remember they're trying to sell it to you. So the first thing they do is flatter you with this big logo section, like the hugest logo ever, right? If you go to a website, they sell you these templates that have these big logos with your name on it. That's because they want you to feel as though it's yours. But the big logo is not helping the bottom line. Let's go to walmart.com and see how big their logo is. Very tiny in the top corner. Let's go to amazon.com. Amazon, even smaller. Let's go to, what's another website? Target.com. Now, do any of these websites have a huge logo? This is Target. No, it's even smaller. So if you're going to use that real estate, the real estate you want to do it for is for an offer. So they offer you something right away, which is shop now. They're getting you to a sales page, something that needs high attention at that point, or something that's popular, swimsuits, top deals. There's a reason for that real estate. Whereas if you go to, let's say, website templates, I guarantee you, in one of the images, it's going to have a huge logo. Now we go into the examples. You can't see it, but that's, what is that in the background? A huge picture logo for no reason. There's nothing there. There's no point for it. Again, the next one, a huge picture of something that has no point. Next template, a huge picture that has no point. That's how they sell a huge thing that has their logo. Okay, that's not helping your bottom line, your money. Okay, the huge logo. You see it in all the templates, huge logo. This one looks like it might have an offer tied to it, so that's fair game. This one has almost like an offer to it. Okay, my website is BusyWorksBeats. Huge logo. So we can see that the biggest companies in the world have the smallest logo, period. And they use every ounce of their website for everything else as far as sales. Amazon, everything else as far as sales. Walmart.com, everything else. They're not worried about their company logo. So all this real estate is kind of being wasted, unfortunately. I know it's probably not under your creative control. So that's one thing you just do over time. It's not something you'd worry about right at the second, but just keep that in mind. I'm a little confused on what I'm here to do. So I would assume you have pre-sales information when people come here. So you kind of tell them what you're about before they come to your website. But people who come here should have something on the homepage that shows them what you're about. Like, what am I here to do? What's your brand about? Because the only thing I see is a song and a search bar, but nothing about what you have to offer or what the value is. So you want to do that on your main page. I'm not sure how much control you have with this system, so I'm not bashing you. I'm just letting you know that's how you can improve over time. Let's go to charts. It's cool you have these functions. I've never seen this style before. That's different. So high Q, not sure what this means. Five favorites. Again, a little vague for me coming here. I don't know what's going on. Some of the latest tracks from HiQ. HiQ. I don't know. Is that a person or maybe a media outlet? HiQ Entertainment. So is this like a platform for like a different music artist? I'm not sure. Let's go to five favorites. Wait, Jay Rich the Kid. I guess these are descriptions. So I like how you can categorize. HiQ is my entertainment group. Oh, I see. I would just try and make it a little bit more clear as to what I'm looking at. Because when I go to charts, I don't know what you're charting. You know, what is a chart? when it says Hi-Q, I'm kind of confused. I don't know who that is. EDM adding more to the website. Awesome. So you're going to learn this over time. It's just the main thing you want to focus on is eliminating confusion when people come to your website. And that can happen even at our website. People get confused about the premium training versus our courses, for example. So it's our job to eliminate that confusion. So that's something you want to focus on. News, cool, you have your blog. I like that kind of layout. It's kind of modern. Okay, so all the pages I went on, I don't see anything about a sales page, however. So let me click on one of your tracks to see how people can even buy it. Okay, so let's do this way. I came up with a better way to go through it. So let's say you send people directly to your website. They click on this song. I'm not sure how to go, like, you know, how many steps does it take to buy the song is what I'm trying to get to right now. Okay, it looks like I can buy this on iTunes. So this must be the thing you're pushing right now is that beat or song. Can't hear it. I gotta poop, bye. We'll be here for a while. So go to Hi-Q. Take your phone with you in the bathroom. Anyway, let's go to this play button. Okay, it's on SoundCloud. So my question is, how do I even buy stuff? Is there stuff to buy? I don't. One click? Not sure what you mean. Let me go back. Okay, so let's just see. If I click on the play button. Whoa. Okay, it's a track. But where? Okay, so I guess this is the buy button. But for the other tracks, I don't see any buy buttons. It just leads me to a SoundCloud. I don't know if they're for purchase. They might not be. So, I mean, if your goal is to sell stuff, firstly, we got to know what we're doing at the main webpage. These are the takeaways. So when we come to your homepage, we got to know what we're here doing. We have to know who you are, what we're doing right away. What's your tagline? If we go to walmart.com, okay, you see up here, Fruit of the Looms has a phrase, wear comfort and breathability mesh. Whatever that means. I guess it's a new product. So that's a thing they're promoting. You come to Walmart. I'm sure they have a phrase somewhere. Maybe they use this banner as their phrase. So I guess their phrase changes. So scorching summer savings, cool off with these crazy low prices, and they show you what you're here about. You're here about those items. Okay, scorching savings on clothing, rollbacks, and clearance for the family. You're here about those items. If I go to your website, I don't know what I'm there to do. So that's one. Second, let me read your comment. I use other people's tracks in my group to give them clout and put them on. Oh, so that they're not selling anything. That's just to help them out. Okay, I would try my hardest. Cord codes aren't fake. We prove it right in the video. I would try my hardest to really differentiate these functions. So the one thing we do in selling things and building a website and building a business is we do too much in one thing. And we need to start segmenting things. Trust me, so that way you know where your energy is going. So the more you separate stuff, the better. I would probably separate the group into its own thing as you have. Let's make that clear. So, okay. And then I guess you're just selling that one song or album. Okay, so I would just say just create products, create songs, create, I don't, you know, beats, whatever it may be, hooks, and add more of these things to it. So hopefully you can take from the other sites we went to and learn about that. Did you guys have any specific questions? Because I don't want to get too critique-y because it's too specific. And, you know, it's not really helping everybody, I can tell. So let's see. Do I sell music? I've sold everything in the medical, from the medical industry over to the music industry over to, you know, businesses. I sell a lot of things. It's not just music. And selling has a process to it. What if I'm selling a rap song? I would focus on using the rap song to sell something else. Like, what are you selling? Merch? Is it merch? Is it what's your product? The song itself, okay, put it this way. Your music is going to get licensed into commercials. The commercials are there to do what? Sell something. So your music is being used to sell something. So what is your song there to do? Is it there to sell your own products or sell somebody else's products? Okay, if I use other people's tracks in my group to give them... Oh, I read that one. Yeah, I don't mean to be too complicated. I apologize. None of my beats are on the website right now. The music beats that I am producing is not a website yet. Okay. Thank you for your participation in that, because it takes a lot of, you know, nerves of steel to really tolerate somebody just going through your website. So I know how it feels. I've had that happen before. And they weren't so nice. They were actually criticizing my music. It didn't feel too good. Should you try to sell music from the beginning or build a following first before you try to sell? Sell immediately. You always want to have your product ready, because if you're building up an audience, what are you... Okay, there's two different approaches. I'm not going to say there's always a nevers, Morgan, but unless you have a strategy on building your audience really fast and having a dedicated strategy on that, you're not going to know how to monetize that. So you want to have products to sell first, then talk to people, get their feedback, and then you change the product to fit whatever they want, and you start catering to them as your audience. And, you know, you build your following you use your products to attract people that relate to those products. So you scale your product versus building this huge following of 200,000 people on Instagram and not even knowing what the heck they want. That's a problem. So you have to know that beforehand. Something tells me the Circle of Fifths did a lot for you. What? We use the Circle of Fifths. Gee whiz, I think you're a hater, so you gotta go. Bye. Din says, should I make my own website? Go for it. Chord codes are real. I utilize that always. And we also teach the Circle of Fifths and the Music Theory Essentials, just to let you know, at busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Do you use any other production softwares? Yes. Machine, Ableton, Logic. What else is out there? Not Pro Tools as much. They're all fun. I mean, they all give you a different approach and different motivations. So I'm trying to get to your questions, because I think your questions can help a lot more people than a solid critique of a website. Where are we at? My question is, what you doing? How was your day? Today I'm actually getting a lot of energy from going live. I found that doing live videos is a lot more energy rewarding than just talking to a screen and then uploading it. It's very different. How do you sell a song exactly? We have a whole course on how to sell beats online. It's a process. You have to learn the process. So go to busyworksbeats.com/sellbeats. It's a lot of parts. It's not just like do this. That's it. You know, you have to, it's a philosophy to it. Okay. Make sure I'm not skipping over too many questions. What about covers so people want to listen to your content? Yeah, I mean, think about the greatest people of all time. They attracted attention. Whether it's Jesus, whether it's Hitler, whether it's Mother Teresa, whether it's Martin Luther King. Who else is like big? Whether it's, you know, the crazy guy in North Korea, they all attract attention. Donald Trump, he attracts attention. So get attention however you can. And then when you get people's attention, then you weed out the people that you're looking for to help them with their problem. And you know, find the people who gravitate around your style of music or whatever you're trying to do. Medical industry, meaning like, no, really in hospitals. Right at Jefferson Hospital in Philadelphia. We went to Lincoln L Hospital. We've gone to, where else did we head down in Philly area? Bryn Mawr. Did we go to Bryn Mawr? No, we didn't go to Bryn Mawr. A couple of other hospitals I can't recall. What if you want to sell songs, like not just beats? What's the best way to go? Sell songs. You have to, okay. When people are selling music, period, like selling CDs, they're also selling a live show. They're not just selling the music. The music is there to get people to their live show. So you have to have an end thing. Something that, okay, so Jay-Z will sell you a CD or a song. Let's say a CD, like it's the old days. He'll sell you a CD for $9.99. The point of him selling you that CD for $9.99 is to get you to his concert where you spend $150. Okay? It's advertising. So when you hear songs from Jay-Z, he's selling something else, whether it's title subscriptions or whether it's whatever he's talking about in the music. It could be his own alcohol brands or whatever he's trying to do. He has something else that he's selling. When you go to concerts, they sell CDs typically as an upsell, it's called. Something that, since you're already here at the concert, why not sell you a CD of the same music that you like? I mean, it's giving you more value out of that moment. So what are you selling beyond the song? You know, are you selling a live show? Are you selling, what's your goal? Is your goal to just get licensed so that commercials pick up your music, or that some, you know, radio, you know, whatever the medium may be, radio, streaming, whatever. What's your goal? So I think you need to have an end goal there. No, not medical marijuana. Talking about other meds that should be banned. A lot of medicine is terrible for the body, but whatever. I'm not going to get into that rant. I asked you this earlier. Are there any music selling sites that don't take royalties? I'm not sure the sites. I mean, I think, let me just type in how to sell or beat sell sites. Beat selling sites. Okay. It's funny because the beat selling sites don't even pop up to on Google. So that's crazy. So that should tell you something. So beat selling websites. Okay. BeatStars is down here. Never heard of these other places. Sell beats online with Shopify. Wow. So Shopify is competing with all the websites here. That's pretty interesting. What am I doing here? I'm trying to help you answer your question, but let me read it again. So I'm not sure if Shopify prices as low as $9 a month. So they're not taking royalties of your sales. They're just taking a flat fee to run the maintenance and the software and the server stuff. So Shopify, I don't understand why people need a beat player. And I'm not bashing all the other beat websites. That's not what I'm here to do. I'm here to build up the industry. But at the same time, you need to look at the options. To which you suggested Shopify. But what I mean is, are there any free? Nothing's free. I mean, nothing's gonna be free, period. If it has to do with making money, nothing's free. PayPal is not free. Credit card companies are not free. They all charge their percentage. They all charge a fee for the transaction because there's money being made. So, you know, it's only fair that you pay your just due if you're making money out of it. Even if you have your own website, you're paying money to the hosting company. You're paying money to the servers. You're paying money to, you know, license the software. So nothing's free. That's just the reality of it. So you got to pay your dues. How do you feel about Reverb Nation? I haven't heard about that in a while. A good way to get people to see you, so basically get heard. Go to busyworksbeats.com/virus. I have a free course here, and I'm showing you it's not a virus. It's just to test people who are too scared to go here. And enter your email, your first name, hit get your bonuses now, and then that'll take you to your email where you get the full course, and it's going to go through these things. Day one, it's going to give you the full course of all this stuff up here on how to do just what you just asked me. How to get heard. Where the females at? The females are places where males aren't. So if you're really asking me, they're in female clothing stores that you never see guys in. They're at decor stores. They're at craftsy places. They're not in GameStop or places a guy would go. They're in the complete opposite locations. Places you're probably scared to go in by yourself. Not you particularly, I mean guys in general. Daniel says, how can I become a music maker? You want to go to busyworksbeats.com/beginners. We have a whole course for free. When you sign up with your email, you're going to get a course on how to learn music production from the ground up. We're going to get you covered there. Proper way to sell beats you produce. Again, There's a lot to selling. There's no like do this and that's it. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/sellbeats. We have a whole course on the structure of selling beats. We're going to update it with more information soon enough. Always AWOL and others like it. I don't know, or also AWOL. I must have missed the context. Oh, I've never heard of those. AWOL. Do people even buy music anymore? They buy it to buy something else. So that's what music is for. Music is created to sell stuff. That's what it's for. That's why you see it in movies. You see it in advertisements. You see it at concerts. You see it on, I mean, it's literally there to sell something. And also to, it's for culture as well, but culture, it's hard to quantize culture. How should I start my website? You want to go to busyworksbeats.com/virus to get that free course. How do you sell beats with Amazon gift cards or something? Never heard of that before. Okay. Where should I invest my money if I want to sell beats? Where should I invest my money if I want to sell beats? Good question. I think that's a more structured question than just how to sell beats. Firstly, you want to have some kind of commerce website because that's where the money's being made. So that's the first thing you're going to need online is a commerce website. You saw how I Googled sell beats and no beat selling websites popped up. That's because they're not, you know, I forget what I put, sell beats online or something. But anyway, you want to come up with a commerce solution, some place that can help you exchange your product for money. That's the first step. Okay, you have to have the product. Where should I invest in my money if you want to sell beats? Then you want to build up an audience. That's going to take time and energy. You can't really buy that. So, I mean, you can through advertisements, but you can't at the same time. So it's a two-edged sword there. I mean, it's a very vague question now. Think about it because I don't know what kind of equipment you have. So I'm assuming you have all the equipment you want. You're talking about website stuff. You need a website. You need a place that you can keep in contact with your clients. And that's about it, really. Those two things. A commerce exchange place. And then a place that you can keep in contact with the people you just sold your thing to. Those two things are essential. Everything else fuels those two things. Chopper says, when should you get a website? As soon as possible. You can live off placements if you do it right. Awesome. Yeah, placements are there to license out the music to get into those things like commercials, movies even. That way your music is being used to sell something else and you get paid for it. Hair Out says everyone should just make their own website. Sometimes that can be a good thing. Sometimes it can't because it depends on your learning curve, your experience. You can easily mess up your website if you don't know how to properly manage one. So it's kind of like, again, you want to have that safety net. By the way, guys, I use WordPress. I have a full developer account with Hostbaby. I've never heard of that one. So I did a lot of coding and customization on my own. Awesome. If you're into that, go for it. You know, that's a whole different career type. What's the best way to drive people to your website? Go to busyworksbeats.com/virus. There is no one way. We're going to show you how to do it, but you have to go to the website busyworksbeats.com/virus. Once you sign up, you're going to be emailed the course for download and you can watch the videos. Okay, it's going in depth about how to do that. What's the proper way to sell your beats as far as pricing? Pricing is, in short, price is what you believe it is. I know this sounds so vague, but if you don't believe somebody's going to buy your $200 beat, you're not going to price your beat at $200. So it's an internal thing. The equation here, D. Griffin, is that when you're setting your prices, the value should be higher than the price. The moment value exceeds price is the time we exchange. And value is not always in what something does for me. It's intangible value as well. So the Gucci shoes you got are the same. They serve the same function as, you know, Skechers. Skechers and Gucci shoes do the same thing. They cover your feet so they don't get blisters and sores from when you walk outside. That's the same utility, but there's intangible value to Gucci versus Skechers. Okay, the intangible value is status if you get the Gucci shoes. It's to lord them over somebody else because they're so expensive, not everybody would even buy them or can afford them. So you lord them over somebody else. So it gives you status, you can lord them over somebody else. And they show, they're also called, in mating, these are called signals. These are signals to show females, if you're a male, that you have the means financially to sustain her security. So this is why when females see guys in, you know, I'm sure you've seen videos where guys rent like a super sports car and then ride up to girls and they're so willing to hop in. It's because that sports car, you cannot fake a sports car. You can't fake that. To get it, you have to have good credit. You have to have however much money it is per month to pay that car off. And you can't fake a supercar. Now, you can rent them, of course. But I mean, in general, you can't fake that. So that's seen as a signal of your success to females. So those three things are what separates Gucci from Skechers. You know, anybody can buy a pair of Skechers because they're affordable. So you can't lord them over anybody else. There's no status equivalent to Skechers because no celebrities really rock Skechers. There's no popularity coolness to Skechers, right? And then thirdly, there's no signal to the female saying that you have the means to provide for her security. So there's none of those three apply to Skechers. And that's what separates Gucci from Skechers. So price deals with value. The moment value exceeds price is when exchange occurs, when money is changed. So that's how price works. Price is a myth. It doesn't matter if I charge you 99 cents for a beat or $9.99. If you think the beat is worth $1,000, you're always going to exchange, whether it's 99 cents or $9.99. It's because the value you perceive is way higher than the price. So that's the problem people are having, is the value that they offer. You need to learn how to increase your value of your offer, called value proposition. How do you propose the value? Just like if you were to meet a girl, would you walk up to her in beat up shirts and dirty jeans and with the worst game ever? Or would you walk up with a suit, a nice smile, and proper conversation? It's two different things. And those two different things are value propositions. Okay. We're not going to do site critiques anymore because it's just too, it doesn't help everybody. Let me scroll back up. Looks like I missed a chunk. Looks like I missed a lot. Okay. So I'm trying to get through your questions one by one, so I'm going to go a little bit faster. Marketing is pretty much finding the demographic of the type of thing you do and gaining people to the source of your products, right? Marketing is like making music. It's a creative art. And it's about getting people's attention. That's what it's about. And matching the right people to your product. That's what marketing is about. So it's the art of getting attention. Morgan says, chord codes is literally how I know how to make chords, to be honest. Awesome. I'm glad they could really help you. Bro, I wish I had a Mac for Logic. A lot of people are starting to get into Logic now. I think that's the best solution for Mac. I don't think Mac really allows any other DAWs to really flourish, except, I guess, Pro Tools and all the other ones, Cubase and whatever else. Do you think most of your information along with the music should be on the homepage? Do you think most of your information along with the music should be on your homepage? I think when people come to your website, again, if we go to Amazon.com, you want to let them understand what you do in like 30 seconds. Excuse me. It's just like wearing an outfit. You know, cops wear a certain outfit because they want you to understand they're the authorities. You know, the president wears a certain suit because he wants you to understand he's the president. Firefighters wear a certain suit because that's what separates them as that thing. So if I'm coming to your website, what is it that separates? What is it? You know, I need to know what I'm here to do. I might have accidentally clicked. A friend might have told me to come here. If I don't get it in the first 10 seconds, less than 30 seconds, then I'm just going to X out and go to a different page or just leave it up and go to a new tab. So Amazon, you know, they do that with their banners. They do that with key phrases. They do it with a lot of things. I know I didn't give the best answer, but it, I realized I would have to go into way much, you know, way more, much more depth. I don't think everything should be on one page. I think everything should be separated. That's what I want to let you know. But at the same time, you want people to understand what they're there to do. Which DAW is your favorite? FL Studio. And thank you. I make sure I get better single day. Thank you, Bill Shiva, for even, am I saying that right? Bill Shiva or Bill Shiva? For even participating. How do you start to sell beats? How do you start to sell beats? I would go to busyworksbeats.com/virus. And when you get there, sign up with your email at the bottom, because we have a whole free course on how to get started for free. On the premium section on your website, wait, I'm on the premium section on your website, but the monthly kit is for my is for May. Please send the link to your website. Maybe I'm on an old one. Well, we do the, if you're talking about the package, we update those every time we have a bundle to offer you. So every month, if we did it every month, it wouldn't be enough content in the downloads. You just have like one or two project files. So we give you the project files, the sounds, in one big package. So it's like a real thing instead of just a wimpy, you know, one or two projects. So that's why we separate them. Let's see. Selling beats for us as well. Love it more. Live stream, please. So this is more technical. So I apologize if it's a little more dry, but this is like the business side of music that people really don't want to get into. Can you make a beat instead of this? Yeah, I know, right? I'm going to do it next. What time is it? Almost 6 o'clock. I'm going to wrap this up at 6 because I think I can feel the energy going away. Let me start back the chat so I know what the heck people are talking about. I forgot how good Swedish fish are. I see you're out the bathroom now, huh? Eating again. Lovely, because I use FL Studio in bootcamp mode on Mac. True. That's a good way to do it. I've never done that on my Mac, so I don't know how it works. I would love to have the PC architecture on my Mac because I would understand what the heck I'm doing with files, but I just don't even know. Mac is a whole different way of dealing with files and folders and all this other stuff. So finally, I made it. Greatest teacher, thank you. Advice on management, do you need it? When we start talking about, okay, so let me get back to Lion's question. What do you think about getting a manager to send your beats to major artists? Now we're getting to this other thing, which is not independence. It's called the majors. We're talking about the quote unquote industry. This is where people don't understand the line. Okay, so you have internet business, which is your own company, your own thing. You're doing whatever you want to do. Then you have another system, which I have a video on. If you want more information, just type in two systems of music, BusyWorks Beats. Two systems of music, BusyWorks Beats. The two main systems in the music industry. This may shock you. Okay, that video is going to break it down. In short, this thing called the music industry is a system. Okay, when the moment you decide to step into that system, you play by their rules, period. That's just how it works. So at that point, you have to start building a team, and that's not easy to do when you have no money. So it's a completely different ballgame when you start talking about managers, lawyers, accountants. Those people need to get paid. They're not doing it for free. So I would suggest starting indie, getting your money up, and slowly building up that professional team, like an accountant, like a lawyer, and then worry about maybe a manager. The thing about managers, I mean, here's the thing. If you've done enough business to where you have enough money to pay for all those professionals, I'd say you have enough experience to be your own manager. There's really, the only way you could leverage a manager at that point is if they have relationships with other artists, or if they're constantly traveling around the world and you just want to be at home getting opportunities, they can help you out that way. But you have to decide that value for yourself. It's not like you have to get this person, because if you get it's a partner. If you get a manager, it's a partner. They're going to ask for a percentage. They're not going to do a flat fee. So they're going to ask for 10%, 20%, 30%. And now every paycheck you get goes to them 30%. And you're like, okay, what's the value I'm getting for this 30%? You have to make sure that they can offer more value than that 30%. But again, it's not so cut and dry. That's why, you know, we're going to have more on that. Okay, maybe I'll do some interviews with people in the industry just to help you understand what they actually do as a manager. Maybe that will help. Advice on management, do you need it? Not starting out, no. What's I don't know, what's lease? Lease means to license, to let another company use your product for a fee. Daniel says, also, what's a good MIDI keyboard? And basically, I have everything else regarding equipment. I'd say I'm looking at this M-Audio 49 control. I'm looking at this one. I want this next. Wait, is that it? Wait, M-Audio 49 CTRL. Should be it. Because it can control your VSTs just using your MIDI controller. I think that's awesome. And I want that next. But what I have, which is good now, is a Novation. What is that thing called? Novation. I would have to go in the other room. 25 key launch key. That's what it's called. Novation launch key 25. That's what I have currently, and it works great. It's a great controller. It's very small. It's very portable. So this is a great option, but I really want this one. Okay. Where are we at here? Jab says at work watching videos. It's because you want to advance in your life. You're sick of being average, so you want to be advanced, and you're dedicated. So that's why you're listening to this live stream. Elise is renting, yes. I watched a couple of your videos and made a pretty basic beat. Oh, darn it, the chat reset. Okay. I'm trying to keep up with you. I know I'm getting a little winded here. That moment when you're broke as F and see expensive things. I want to get you to a point where you can look at this MIDI keyboard and say, okay, I want it, and just grab it. That's what this video is about. But I understand it's a process. I can't just be like, do this, and you're going to be, you know, making, you know, thousands and thousands overnight, because that's not how it works. You have to learn step by step. So I can give you all the advice in the world, but it's going to take a while to really absorb it and really apply it all. Okay, so let me get to the major questions. I see a question about copyright, I think. Did I see that? Would you recommend going through the whole process of copywriting your music through the U.S. Copyright Office before selling, leasing your music, or is it not necessary? Let me see. Okay, so they used to have it right on copyright.gov, the music. I'm just going to type in copyright.gov/music, and let's see. Copyright registration of music. Claims to copyright is probably... No, they used to have a place where you could have a definition of what it meant. Elements of unit publication submitted registration. No, that's like the application fee. Where is the... So you have to go through this website. They redid it. Okay, but you want to go through here. Maybe just do a Google search to narrow it down, unless we can search music copyright. Whoops, forgot a T. Copyright registration of music. Here we go. PDF. So you want to read through this. This is what I read through a long time ago. It basically says that once you publish something online, it's copyrighted. Let me see if I can find the sentence. Let me see here. It's going to take me a while to read, so this might be boring. The circular explains the difference. Da, da, da. Okay. Although they're separate works, maybe registered together as ones. Okay. Filing an online claim. Anyway, read through this document. It's too long to kind of skim. But basically, when you put something online, it's copyrighted right away, as soon as it's made public. You want to read that. That's going to give you the definition of what you're asking me. So you can read it for word, what it means. I lost my spot. Where was I at? Okay, we were up here. You know, scales. I appreciate you all for participating, helping other producers out and artists. Why don't you work with major artists? We work with huge companies. We work with, here's the thing. A lot of people are like, which artist do you work with? I don't view artists like, let me show you something. Pyramid Corporate. Let me show you some visuals and make it a little Illuminati for a minute. I wish they had linear pyramids. But think about it this way, okay? A company, a record label, whoever it is, the CEO is at the top, let's just say. Artists are way down here. Right, they might be making a lot of money, but there's people in power who put them in position. So when you're talking, when not you, but anybody, if you're just aiming for the artist, they're an end product of the people up here. And these people make decisions for the people down here. So we're focused on the people up here. Okay, not the people down at the bottom who can get X'd out at any moment. You know, I'm not saying it's not a valid way to do business, and I'm not belittling the artist. I'm saying the way I think about an artist is a little bit different. You know, we're dealing with the record labels, the companies, the manufacturing companies. We're dealing with those folks, not their end product. You know, let me think of a better example. Like, how can I think about this? Let's say the bike called Huffy. I'm sure you've seen bike shops around your area, right? They have bike shops. And in that bike shop, they sell probably Huffies. So instead of doing business with the bike shop, I do business with the people who make the bikes. You understand what I'm saying there? So we go to the core company, not necessarily the product of the company. So I hope that made sense. And I'm not trying to like sound so high and mighty. I just mean, I want you to open your mind to how much business there is out there. It's not just artists out there. It's a lot more than artistry. What basic equipment do you need to start as a DJ? Good question. We haven't focused on DJing yet, so I can't really give you an in-depth answer to that. But I think you can just grab Traktor. But it depends on your price range. Traktor is a program that you can run your software through. And Native Instruments has a DJ controller right on Native Instruments. Traktor Control. Now, it's pretty pricey. So Traktor itself, that's pretty cheap, actually. $50? 50% off. So $50 for their program and then $600 for the controller. So you're spending at least $600. You can get the smaller controllers, but I don't know how much they can do compared to the turntable thing that you're going to need to scratch and do all this like tempo syncing and all this type of stuff. So I would look into that Native Instruments. I would just start there. And if once you over time, you might like Pioneer, you might like something else. So I would just start there because they make it very streamlined with all their other products. All right. I just want to answer all your questions because I don't want to leave you confused. Make music here, but your tips also have short stories. Awesome. What's the best starter price? What's the best starter price USB mixer audio interface? I'd say go with the Scarlett 2i2. I think they have something cheaper than this even. But this is like a great value. And it has a good sound. I used this back in the beginning. You see it in a couple of your favorite producer studios. Not like big time producers, but in Johnny Giuliano's studio, he had one of these, I believe, and he was making crazy tracks. And I mean, it does the job. Okay, and you can upgrade over time. So that's a great place to start. Game, how can I find people to rap on my beats? You want to go through our course, busyworksbeats.com/virus. It's a free course when you sign up with your email. It's a whole system on how to get, you know, how to attract what you're looking for. What's a better marketing strategy in your opinion, beat selling websites or personal marketing via email websites? Well, let's go to the first option. Beat selling websites aren't doing anything for you except hosting your material and making it easier for people to find it through search. Other than that, they're not pushing your website. So that's what you need to realize. Personal marketing via email, that's you get to choose your marketing medium. Email is how you keep in touch with people. So even if they come to your beat website, it's kind of like, going into any store, any modern store, any store in the mall. You go in and you leave. You just go in and you leave. They don't capture any information about who you are, what's your number, so you can keep in contact, maybe tell you about our deals. And that's where a lot of companies are failing because people come to your website and nobody captures any information about the person who was interested enough to come to your website. So that's a big mistake people are dropping the ball on. And I don't know if the beat selling website offers that or not. So you're eventually probably going to want your own website, but until then you're going to need something to help you get there. So you can use whatever platform you like. Don't you think information should be free? No. Don't you Don't you think information should be free for aspiring new producers? No, not necessarily. Because free information comes from your family. Nothing's free. School is not free. Kindergarten is not free. Somebody's paying for that teacher to teach you. It's not free information. You know, and the information you do get for free, you have to question, like a PSA from the government, like those don't smoke campaigns, like what's it called, truth something, tell the truth or something, the smoking things. There's a study done, a scientific study that shows that when people say don't smoke, they want to smoke more. So those campaigns are fueling smokers, believe it or not. It sounds ridiculous. There's a study done by a marketing agency. And when people are, yes, I'm just going to leave it at that. You can do your own research, but that's how crazy it is out here. So don't you think, no, I don't think information should be free. I think good information is not given to the masses, because if everybody had it, they'd use it for evil. And people with good information usually hold it towards their family. Okay. And if you're not part of their family, there's a wall. There's a trust wall called money. They want you to pay for it or some kind of other thing before they just give you all this information for free. So there's always a price for everything. Nothing's free. Books used to be for the elites. Nobody used to be able to read, believe it or not. If you weren't rich, you didn't have any books and you didn't know how to read. So information is not free. Producers who want to learn everything, and even if something's free, we still pay for internet. You know, there's always a cost somewhere along the lines. Nothing's really free. I mean, if you track it all the way back to the coal that we use for electricity, that's not free. So no, nothing's really free. Producers who want to learn everything and can't afford your products. Oh, as far as my products, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to go on that rant. And then you asked me about my products. You can go right to busyworksbeats.com/. Well, it depends on what you want to learn. I don't know what you would like to learn, but you said for an aspiring new producer. So go to busyworksbeats.com/beginners, because I have a whole free course for you. And that's absolutely free. This is information I'm willing to share, because you need it to get started. Okay, and we give that out for free, because once you start learning how to be a music producer, you can fully tap into your potential. And now you can move on and actually learn some things. Okay, so Juma says, do you have to make trap in order to sell? I feel like I just had deja vu for some reason. Do you have to make trap in order to sell? You have to ask your audience what they want. Let me update the chat, because I know people are like, where's my comment? I don't want to get stuck on too many questions. I said I was going to wrap this up at 6. We're going over time. So let me answer 3 more questions. I'm closing my eyes and picking a question. Where are we at? Here. What mic do you have and what price was it? By the way, quick shout out to the homie Pro Tool 44i. I have a U87 from Neumann, and I got it used. So it was not the full price. I got it used. Okay. So look for used gear. But if you're buying used gear, check the outputs. Make sure stuff's not dented. Make sure you have the right outputs. Because I bought a preamp and I thought it was going to have an XLR output, but it had a quarter inch output, and it just threw me off. So just make sure you check all that stuff before you buy used gear. And 2 more questions. Let me close my eyes and down here. I want to create a kit out of the sounds I already have, but I have so many sounds to sort through. I just want a kit with all the sounds I love. Is there any suggestions? I don't know what you really love, but you just said it. You want to, over time, once you start tracks and you're like, this is my track, I love this kick, you make a little small folder with your favorites. And over time, you're going to have more and more favorites. And just keep saving sounds to that folder until it becomes a thing. And let's answer 1 more question, then we got to wrap this one up. Because I could tell people really don't care about selling beats, even though they complain about not selling beats. You just can't win. But anyway, what information are you not really willing to share, I guess? A lot of information, because it's not for everybody. You know, I'm sure the president doesn't tell us the secrets in the White House for a reason. If we knew the secrets, it would compromise a lot of American things. same with your business. You can't just give everything out to everybody. That's actually doing a disservice, okay? Because you can be giving technology to the enemy, okay? And they could just use it for evil. So you got to be really careful. You're talking to each other, blah, blah, blah. Glad I tuned in. Awesome. What do you think about SongTrader? I've heard of it, but let me visit. SongTrader. Just real quick, let's see what they do. The music solution, SongTrader, this is what you need for your website. Just a quick, what do you do, right? SongTrader is a revolutionary global licensing platform. Oh, they license music, providing access to real artist songs. Okay, cool. So they do, I guess they compile music into a catalog and people buy memberships to the website and they can license it out. So it's kind of like other websites I've been to. So it's like a music library from what I see. Go for it. If that's something you want to try out, it's an extra stream of income as long as they don't ask for the rights to your music or anything. Do you stream on Twitch? No, not yet. I understand people want me to do it, but again, I'm not trying to build up a Twitch following, but we'll see. Do we need instruments to be a producer? Because I'm broke. I would start at busyworksbeats.com/beginners. We're going to go through all the solutions on how to, you know, go from step one to step 1000. Is it wise to shop for a label? Again, you have to sit down and ask. I don't know if I did a video on this. Let me look. Do you need label? Busyworks Beats. I'm all about independence. The only reason I would use a bigger company is for leverage. And if I don't know if I have any videos on leverage, I swear I did one. Using sample resources as leverage. How to use leverage. Okay. So this is done 2 years ago, but it's the same concept. So go watch that video. Just type in leverage Busyworks Beats. That's the only time you want to look for other companies is to leverage. What can you get out of that trade that benefits both of you or just you or whatever? Because it's an equation and it has a lot of variables. Is the most reasonable USB audio mixer interface that's also a control surface? I don't know what you mean by control surface, like the ones that control Pro Tools, or if you're talking about just like a mixer. What's the most reasonable USB mixer interface? I don't really use these, so I can't advise you too much on these. I would just go by price, because the reason I say that is because preamps are now pretty much the same. They're all pretty much the same as far as the audio interface for the most part. I'm not saying they all do the same things, but for the price increases, it's not like you're running it through an SSL console. So it's just used for inputs and outputs. So you don't want to like waste money on that if you're not getting the highest quality thing. Thanks for the info you've shared today. It's been great. Awesome. Thank you. I joined late. Oh man, you're going to have to rewind. Even watch the last live stream. You got 2 more hours where I live. Oh, I see what you're saying. I'm going to go till 6. We're in the Eastern time. It's 6:12. I got to wrap this up. It's getting a little dry. And plus, I want to make music for you anyway. Show you some techniques. They haven't even told us about the ETs yet. Extraterrestrials. True. Hi, when will you make a listening feedback stream? We're going to have that for the group. It's going to be private, however, because a lot of different reasons. Actually, let's do it on YouTube just to kickstart it. And then we're going to go private for the Facebook group. We'll do that. Is my business doing well? I mean, if you could just look at our YouTube and tell we're still growing, of course. We're only growing because of you. Like, you joined today because we're giving you value. And that's what I hope to do, is just give you value and more value to people around the world. So yes, I love giving. I love helping people out. Thanks for the knowledge. The Sound Oracle shouted you in his live. Will you join his podcast? I should give him a call. I'm not sure how he does his podcast. I watch him on YouTube, but I think he does them over either Facebook Live or Instagram. So Neymar, if you can tell me which platform he uses, whether it's Instagram or Facebook, I'd appreciate that. Because I'm starting to like podcasts a little bit more. You know, music podcasts. I think it's nice to just talk about topics and just kind of broaden our awareness in music a little bit instead of just the music all the time. Your mouse is an instrument. That should be a quote. I'm going to make a shirt that says your mouse is an instrument and just have a picture of a mouse. Do you know Crank Lucas? I think he's from Philadelphia area and he's super talented. I don't know him, but I've known of him for a very long time, ever since he first started. And I mean, he knows how to get attention. So that's marketing. He's getting tons of attention and I just hope he can monetize it because he puts in a lot of work. I have friends which make 8 beats a day. Does it take time and experience to make beats fast? Yeah, I mean, it's like asking, can you make a cake fast? If you don't know the first thing about making a cake, you're going to have to learn, right? How to mix the flour with the eggs, right? But once you learn how to do that, then you can do it faster. And you're like, oh, I know this step. I know this step. It's kind of like when you put a bookshelf together. The first time, it takes you forever to read through the manual and to understand which pieces are which. But when you put the second bookshelf together after your first one, you're like, oh, I know where this piece goes. I know where this goes. So then you get faster and faster. But that's only through knowing the process. And that's called practicing. Knowing the process. I use FL Studio. Wait, what? That controls the FL Studio. I use FL Studio. Novation keyboards. I'll get into all this equipment talk. We're going to get into that different one. Because I'm going on and on and on. I got to wrap this up. We're going to live stream a beat right after this. How about we do beat feedback? Oh, Instagram. I need to probably follow. I don't follow too many people on Instagram. I should really unfollow a bunch of people. I don't like Instagram. I think they're just using us. Anyway, see, I got on my phone. I'm going to wrap this up. Let's do beat critiques next, and then we're going to get into tutorial stuff after that. Yeah, I should do a weekly. The reason we took a break was because YouTube has a new policy. And it just didn't work well with the beat critiques, but we'll do it. But the thing is, it's going to be live and it's going to get archived, meaning it's not going to be public. And then we'll have more for our producer community. I just had to wait till I got some equipment. All right, so enough talking. Let's move into the beat feedback.